being here to pray and worship this morning.
Tell me what's wrong.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, communion with the Holy Spirit, be with you all. And my dear friends, as we gather this morning, grieving this very tragic loss, as we remember Lucy Fernandez, we gather to pray for her eternal rest. We gather to pray for the consolation of her loved ones. We pray at this liturgy, of course, for the ongoing healing and recovery of all those affected by this tragedy. And we gather in the name of Christ. What does that mean? That means that if we live in Christ, if we live in His reality as Lucy has, Lucy who has lived in Christ, Lucy who so eloquently, so beautifully, in her short span of years and relative to what many live, in that brief time, gave so much life, gave so much light. She who radiated so much beauty and touched the lives of so many, she who made them better by her presence. She who has died in Christ, she now, our faith reveals to us that she lives on eternally in Christ. We thank the Lord in the midst of the sadness, in the midst of the pain that we feel. We thank the Lord that in Him, in His name, life goes on. And it goes on far better than it can ever go here in this realm. So we begin this liturgy, as always, by calling to mind our sins, calling to mind all those times when, not because we're bad people, but because of our weaknesses, we're overwhelmed by life and we make mistakes. We ask the Lord to forgive our sins, to all the more deepen our love for Him, and to renew all of us in His light. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that, through this mystery, your servant Lucy, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through Him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. Please be seated. Let us now listen to the proclamation of God's word. The person who will be proclaiming the first reading may now come forward and do so.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. But the souls of the just are in the hand of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seemed, in the view of the foolish, to be dead, and their passing away was thought an affliction, and their going forth from us utter destruction. But they are in peace, for if before people indeed they be punished, yet is their hope full of immortality. Chastise a little, they shall be greatly blessed, because God tried them and found them worthy of himself. As gold in the furnace, he proved them, and as sacrificial offerings, he took them to himself. In the time of their visitation, they shall shine and shall dart about as sparks through stubble. They shall judge nations and rule over peoples, and the Lord shall be their king forever. To those who trust in God shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and God's care is with the elect. The word of the Lord.
Let us now listen to the proclamation of the second reading. The person who will do so may kindly come forward.
First Thessalonians chapter 4, verses 13 through 18, a reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. We do not want you to be unaware, brothers and sisters, about those who have fallen asleep, so that you may not grieve like the rest who have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose, so too will God through Jesus bring with him those who have fallen asleep. Indeed, we tell you this on the word of the Lord, that we who are alive, who are left until the coming of the Lord, will surely not precede those who have fallen asleep. For the Lord himself, with a word of command, with the voice of an archangel, and the trumpet of God, will come down from heaven, and the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive, who are left, will be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. Thus we shall always be with the Lord. Therefore, console one another with these words. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, "You are the salt of the earth. But if salt loses its taste, with what can it be seasoned? It is no longer good for anything but to be thrown out and trampled underfoot. You are the light of the world. A city set on a mountain cannot be hidden, nor do they light a lamp and then put it under a bushel basket. It is set on a lampstand, where it gives light to all in the house. Just so, your light must shine before others, that they may see your good deeds and glorify your heavenly Father." The Gospel of the Lord. The darker the night, the brighter the light. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. On the day of our baptism, the deacon lit a candle from the Easter candle, handed it to Melly and Andy, and said, "Receive the light of Christ. Parents and godparents, this light is entrusted to you to be kept burning brightly. This child of yours has been enlightened by Christ. She is to walk always as a child of the light. May she keep the flame of faith alive in her heart. When the Lord comes, may she go out to meet him with all the saints in the heavenly kingdom." The gospel, chosen today for the celebration of Lucy's life, was the gospel from the opening mass for the new school year. And the theme for the new school year was, "Be the salt and follow the light." This just happened to be Lucy's last mass with her other family, the older family. And if anyone embodied the spirit, the philosophy of Ola, it would be Lucy Fernandez. With Christ in our heart and Mary in all things. This became very obvious, as over the last few days, the girls would share their thoughts on Lucy. Words like her smile, her laughter, her hugs. But there was one word that seemed to sum everything up. So many of them said, "Lucy was always sweet." I think it would be a mistake to look at the sweet, beautiful young life that has been taken away from us much too soon and think that this is the end of her story, the end of the story. I truly believe that her light will continue to shine. You see, Lucy left us a tremendous legacy. Her teachings on life itself. We learn from her that life is fragile, which it truly is. But whether long or short, life can be sweet and beautiful when it is lived well. That is, stay always close to Jesus. Be kind, be gentle, be generous with each other. Be the calm in the storm. Be peace in the midst of chaos. Be the joy in the midst of sadness. And be the light in the midst of darkness. Melly, Andy, Kevin, grandmas and grandpas, you all know better than anyone how well Lucy carried that light throughout her life. In fact, you were and are the very instruments of that light. You taught her the most important lesson in life. You taught Lucy to love. And love is what turns and keeps the light on. We thank you for that. In her sophomore year, Lucy walked into my classroom, took her seat in the third row. She was that quiet type, quiet type of student, right? But that did not conceal her sense of humor. She was also a prankster, which her friends can attest to. Now, humor and prankster put together make up for a happy child, doesn't it? I also learned that beneath that happiness, there was also a very sensitive Lucy, sensitive to the needs of others. She did not do the good deeds to be recognized. She never did ever want the limelight, but would always bring the light if and when it was needed. The smile was to let you know that she was there if you needed her. The laughter was in case you had missed the message of the smile. And the hug was to tell you, here I am. The smile, the laughter, the hug, all they were was simply a reflection of what was in her heart, how she felt about you. So in the midst of the sorrow and pain we are feeling this morning, we might very much be tempted to think that sweet Lucy's light has now been extinguished. Not so. Nothing could be farther from the truth. That same light of Christ that was passed on to her at her baptism, that light still burns brightly. The light that has overcome all things, even death itself, is here with us today, ready to illuminate whatever doubts we may have, ready to comfort and console us, ready to lift Lucy to the place from whence she came, her proper place, to be with our Father in heaven. We are thankful to Lucy for the life's lessons she has taught us. We give thanks and praise to God for giving Lucy to us, for sharing his love for us through her. We now return her to God. And as God did not lose her in the giving, so we do not lose her in the return. Lucy, one last assignment, one last thing. In your essay titled Lucy Sita, you wrote, I was destined to be the bringer of light. I was destined to be the bringer of light. And you even said your grandma gave you this nickname, Lucicita de mi vida, which means light of my life. You're not only the light in grandma's life, you're also the light in our life. We have all been touched by your light, and we have felt the warmth of your love. So, Lucy, bring it on. Keep shining. Shine on mom and dad, and shine on Kevin, your brother, and your grandmas and your grandpas. Shine on Katie and Coco and Mia. Shine on all your friends. Shine on all of us here. Keep shining, sweet and beautiful Lucy, beloved child of God. Keep smiling. We love you, Lucy. Amen.
My dear friends, let us all now stand as we prepare to voice our petitions for Lucy's eternal rest and many others. And as we prepare ourselves to do so, I invite those who will be bringing up the gifts to now proceed through the center aisle to the back of the church so that you may be ready for the presentation of the gifts. But let us now, with faith and hope in Almighty God, voice our petitions to Him.
The response will be, hear our prayer. In baptism, Lucy received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead her over the waters of death. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Our sister Lucy was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome her into the halls of the heavenly banquet. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For the family and friends of Lucy, that they may be consoled in their grief by the Lord, who wept at the death of his friend Lazarus. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For the continued healing of Kathy Puig, Mia Rodriguez, and those impacted by this tragedy, that they may find strength and comfort in their community and God's light in the darkness. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Many friends and members of our families have gone before us and await the kingdom. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We are assembled here in faith and confidence to pray for our sister Lucy. Strengthen our hope so that we may live in the expectation of your Son's coming. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, you who sent us your Son, who is the resurrection and the life, so that we may have life and have it in abundance, listen to these prayers that we have just voiced in the midst of our pain. Be aware of all the other prayers that we always silently present to you with the deepest yearnings of our heart, and lead us to true life in your Son. And we ask this through Jesus Christ, our risen Lord. Amen. Please be seated as we proceed with the presentation of the gifts. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Lucy, we beseech your mercy that she who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just. It is our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him, the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the host and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time that he was betrayed and he entered willingly into his passion, he himself took bread. Giving you thanks, he broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice once more, giving you thanks. He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. You have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and the blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, our auxiliary bishop, and all the clergy.
Remember your servant Lucy, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who was united with your son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her blessed spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, with him, in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
At the Savior's command and formed by his divine teaching, we now dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, O Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will. Live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Behold Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. My dear friends, let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our sister Lucy may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Please be seated, as we will now be addressed by family and friends.
A few weeks ago, Lucy's close friends and I wanted Lucy to celebrate her birthday without giving her the stress of event planning. So we threw her a surprise party. Lucy was always going the extra mile for us, so we wanted to repay her with the perfect day where she would be surrounded by love. We took care of decor, food, and guests so that she wouldn't have to. It ended up being the most beautiful celebration of Lucy. However, I have a secret to confess. It was a totally fake surprise party. Lucy knew every detail about the party. She had even picked the date. Her expert organization skills kicked in, and even though we said we would take care of everything, she helped in any way she could. She had even spent the night before the party practicing her fake reaction to her fake surprise, which she then executed perfectly. This party, in hindsight, is a perfect representation of our girl, Lucy. We invited people from different chapters of her life, and we got to see just how impactful Lucy's love really was when all these groups got together to celebrate her. She danced and sang her favorite songs while making sure everyone else was having an equally good time. She was at her happiest. After the party, I went to start cleaning up, only to find everything spotless, of course. Lucy had picked everything up in seconds. She was always the most diligent, hardworking, and caring person I've ever known. Anyone who met Lucy, even just for a moment, was immediately touched by the light within her. She was always there when you needed a helping hand or a joke. She was radiantly funny, with the most beautiful smile and a trademark laugh that I can still hear. The light in Lucy's soul was never stifled and always contagious. How did we get lucky enough to have this ray of sunshine in our lives? Throughout our years together, she inspired me to be better, like she did with everyone she met. Even at a young age, in elementary and middle school, she knew how to shine her light. In the lunch cafeteria, if she saw you without a seat, she'd pull up a chair for you. In recess, she'd be quick to start singing and dancing and spreading so much joy. Our whole class knew how special she was when she was voted for an eighth grade superlative. She was voted best personality. Throughout high school, Lucy and I were inseparable. Both in and out of the classroom, I can't remember a time where she wasn't making everyone laugh. Walking through the school hallways with Lucy meant stopping to share a smile with everyone. She always left people happier than they were before they saw her. And our class of 2023 will forever hold her in our hearts. I'd always poke fun at her for taking the most detailed notes and carrying the biggest calendar, but I would always run to her when I forgot what our test was going to be on. She was gloriously meticulous in ways I could never understand, and in ways that perfectly balanced my sporadicness. Her strengths filled in my weaknesses, and I will be forever grateful for the things she has taught me. No matter the task, she strived for perfection, which I think says a lot about her attitude towards life in general. She saw the good in everyone and everything. Meli and Angie, you raised the most incredible daughter with the help of Abi, Abu, Nana, and Titi. Meli, Lucy carried your grace, strength, and confidence with her wherever she went. She would always tell me how she had the wisest and most amazing role model. Andy, I know Lulu was a tough critic of your jokes, but she took your joy and lively attitude to everyone who knew her. She wanted to follow in your footsteps as an FSU graduate and for some time as a lawyer. Lucy truly admired every part of you. KK, Lucy was so proud of you. She always wanted to see you succeed and always told me how much she loved you, even if you stepped on her rug with shoes on. She will always be there for you, KK, and will shine her light down on all of us forever. Lucy, thank you. Thank you for always giving us strength, laughter, and the most special memories. Your life was truly a blessing. Thank you for sharing your love and light. You changed the world, Lou. I will do my best to love like you did, but you left big shoes to fill. To know you has been our greatest blessing. All I can say is I love you. I love you, I love you, I love you, and we will all love you forever.
I stand here today to pay tribute to the most beautiful, joyful soul and the most precious person in my life, Lucy Fernandez. Lucy and I met 6 years ago at Living Dolls Dance Factory in a jazz class on a regular Tuesday evening. At the time, her and I solely knew of each other based on the fact that we had mutual friends. Even though 6 years doesn't seem like a lot, it felt as if we knew each other for a lifetime. Immediately, we clicked over time, and that everlasting bond started to flourish. As we grew closer, we realized we lived extremely close, and we started to carpool together. We asked each other for help, either taking or picking up whenever it was needed. Once the carpool started, we discovered that our moms actually did know each other since they used to work together. I remember our moms being so shocked with the fact that we connected so easily without knowing any background on each other. From there, our friendship soared, and I got the chance to grow with her every step of the way. Lucy was, and still is, someone who always worked her hardest, no matter what it was. From joining the swim and track and field team, which most know was extremely short-lived on our part, to studying for hours for a small vocab quiz, she gave it her all. She had an undying determination to constantly succeed and become her best self. From last year to this year, her journey to become her best self bloomed, and I got the chance to follow her on it. As a friend, I don't think I've ever felt so proud of someone. Although she went through her ups and downs, Lucy made it through and chose love in everything, especially with herself. She chose to connect with God rather than go through the motions. She chose to be present rather than distant in every single thing that she did. She was always down to do anything that helped her or others become a better person. With that, she quickly became my person and even my gym buddy. Even though I was the type to sleep in, she never stopped trying to drag me to hot yoga on Saturday mornings. Lucy was the freest of spirits, and it's something I admire her for beyond words. Her spontaneous, yet thought through, because it's Lucy, decision-making was something that made her live her best life. She had that spark in her eyes, one of drive, determination, and most evidently, the hunger for adventure and amazing life experiences. As she would call it, it was her Mamma Mia dream. Mamma Mia was her favorite movie, and it was a movie that inspired her to take that chance in whatever she did. I remember her telling me how she always wanted to travel the world, and luckily, these past 2 summers, she got that chance, and I couldn't be happier for her. When she went on Blue Missions in the summer of 2021, she got the opportunity to discover genuine happiness through helping others, and once she returned, she was quick to share that with others. Her selflessness and ability to make others feel loved and special was one of her many talents that made her our beloved Lucy. This past summer, we got the opportunity to study abroad in Spain, and there she did it all. And that spark in her eyes I previously mentioned was constantly present, even when we were walking up the four flights of stairs we took to get to our dorms every day. I want to end off by sharing the moment she and I had on our last day of that trip in Madrid. Even though we had to wake up at 4 a.m. the next morning, she and I decided to enjoy our last moments shopping together and walking around the city. As our night started to come to an end, we spoke about how this was the start of it all, and our lives would be filled with experiences such as this for the rest of it. Although she's not here physically, I still stand to hold that conversation to be forever true in my heart and in the hearts of many. It's important that we let Lucy's light shine through us and live out her life's mission. In fact, Lucy's with us right now and will always help us gain the strength to open the blinds every morning, no matter how hard it may be. Lucy, I will always love you. Thank you for changing my life and making me and many others so happy.
Lucy, what are we gonna do without you? She brought so much joy, not only to my life, but to everyone else's around her. Lucy was a perfect example of what we should all try to be like. She was loving, joyful, and had such a great sense of humor. She was perfect. I knew her for 17 years, and I never saw her without a smile on her face. She lit up every single room she walked into, and never failed to make any of us laugh. Lucy takes after her dad, Andy, and that everything always had to be spotless. Lucy could walk into my room, which is never too clean, and walk out 10 minutes later with the room smelling like the inside of a Fabuloso bottle. I know she's having a great time decorating and cleaning her new room in heaven while probably watching Mamma Mia on repeat with no interruptions for as long as she wants. For those who knew her, we will all miss the sound of her voice and her distinct laugh. I have shared so many memories with her, and it makes me so happy that she is impacting others the way that she impacted me. It seems like just hours ago, we were together at our weekly dinners on Paola's boat, laughing at something Nicholas had just said. It's not going to be the same without you there, Lucy. Paola, Nicholas, and all of Lucy's closest friends, we will get through this together, and I love all of you so much. Nino and Titi, I love you guys so much, and it breaks my heart to see you guys go through this. KK, please know that I'm always here for you, and I'll always have your back. If you ever need anything, please call me. You're my brother. I love you, dude. This always seems to happen to the best people. Nobody gets it, and we will probably never get it. But to my best friend, I've never had a relationship so special with anyone else. I love you so much, and I'm gonna miss you putting a smile on my face. And I'll see you again, Lulu. I love you, bro. Jimbo.
Good morning. For those of you that don't know me, my name is Arturo Fernandez. I'm Lucy's uncle and godfather. Please forgive me in advance. I know this eulogy is going to be particularly difficult for me to complete, but I know Lucy's standing here with me and will help me along the way. I'd like to start by thanking you all for attending these services and supporting each of us, and especially supporting Andy, Melly, and Kevin through this unimaginable tragedy that has left us without our beloved Lucy, Lulu Bird, Lulu Bell, Lucecita de mi vida, Lou, Mama Mooch, the list goes on and on and on. She had many names. You've come from all over this community, whether because you were blessed to have known her or were moved by the tragedy and are here to console family and friends. You are classmates, teachers, clergy, friends, family, acquaintances, co-workers, among others. And your presence is recognized by our family and appreciated by us all. As we've begun working through the grief of Lucy's passing, as a family, we've been taken aback by the outpouring of support from this community, from this parish, and from so many schools in the city. Sister Carmen and the entire Our Lady of Lourdes community exemplified the devotion to sisterhood in countless ways, not only during the several prayers, rosaries, and vigils, but also in your presence at the hospital as we waited for the news on Lucy. And of course, through the beautiful music and thoughtful words shared at Friday's Mass in Lucy's honor, as well as today. Your efforts will never be forgotten. Father Alvarez and Miss Oliva, you opened up Lucy's former home, and of course we know, once a king, always a king, and gathered the parish and the school community in celebration of Lucy's life on Wednesday and yet again today. Thank you for honoring Lucy in such a meaningful manner. Carrollton Belen Columbus, you have gone above and beyond to support Lucy, even though she wasn't one of your own. And I know I'm missing a few schools, but aside from just being remarkable, these efforts exemplify the definition in my eyes of one body, a statement I have heard repeated this week. One body is a reference to a Romans passage that has been mentioned in the context of honoring Lucy, and I find that it suits her so well. It states as follows: for just as each of us has one body with many members, and these members do not all have the same function, so in Christ we, through many, form one body, and each member belongs to all the others. This passage is about love and unity, and nothing describes Lucy better than those two words. For those of you who knew her, you know that Lucy loved like no other. Her smile was contagious and would light up the room. Her embraces, when she would let you, would make you melt, and her laugh would warm your soul. Lucy did not like division, drama, or conflict. Instead, she promoted peace, closeness, faith, and caring for each other. Although Lucy shied away from the spotlight, Lucy loved having all of her friends and family together with her, enjoying time together, sharing a meal, or shopping, which, you know, as a teenage girl would do. All of it in the spirit of light and love. It reminds me of how Lucy entered into this world. As you heard during the Mass on Friday, Lucy was born on the night of Hurricane Katrina, or the night that Hurricane Katrina made landfall in Miami. Being our first niece and grandchild, feeder bands and debris couldn't stop us all from rushing to the hospital to meet her. The widespread power outages extended to the hospital while Melly labored for hours. But because Lucy is light and love at her core, it came as no surprise that at the very moment Lucy was born, the power returned and the lights all came back on. Upon witnessing the event, the doctors announced in excitement and maybe a little shock, "Oh Lord, she has brought light back into this world." It is only fitting that she did that, as her name is Luciana, which means light. No question that Lucy brought light into our lives when she was born. You can ask any of us, and we will all tell you that our memories with Lucy are so rich. She was our first baby girl before we had children and baby girls of our own. From day one, she owned us. She owned her parents, her grandparents, her uncles and aunts, and of course me. She had us wrapped around her baby fingers. At the time she was born, I was only dating Michelle, my wife. But instantly, even Michelle became enamored by Lucy and committed to ensuring Lucy was a part of her life, regardless of the outcome of our relationship. In fact, Michelle would tell me, "If we break up, that's fine, but I'm sticking with Lucy with or without you." We ended up getting married, but the message was clear. Lucy is our little angel, and she radiated a light and goodness that we simply couldn't get enough of. As she got older, her light and goodness never extinguished. In fact, it was quite the opposite. Lucy was a role model child, a good student, a loyal friend, a loving member of her family, and an overall powerful voice, even though it may not have been the loudest voice in the room. Her approach, although understated, had the ability to positively influence others without the need for confrontation. She was the silent influencer. Being the first of all the grandchildren, Lucy set the example, and boy, did she leave a mark. Lucy never got in trouble or received poor grades on her report card. She was well-liked by her peers, her teachers, coaches, and as a bonus, her room was always impeccable. Nothing was ever out of place or out of order. She found joy in cleanliness like no one I've ever met. As her friends would say, if Lucy were here, she'd probably be home swiffering up and down the aisles right now. Overall, the example that Lucy set for her cousins, Natalia, Caterina, Harrison, Henry, Sebastian, and Theo, and of course her brother Kevin, is something for which, as parents, we will always be grateful. This year, Lucy began applying for college and was so excited to embark on the college application process. As part of that process, Lucy was committed to finding her passion and figuring out what she wanted to be. Initially, she wanted to be a lawyer, just like a few of us, but then she went to her father's office and thought it was the most boring thing she had ever endured in her life. So she quickly scratched that off the list. Most recently, she seemed really excited about pursuing physical therapy, a dream I do not think she had the opportunity to fully flesh out. The journey to discover her calling in life was something Lucy was embracing with all of her heart and soul. And as her family, it was so fun to watch her embarking on that quest and listening to her discoveries along the way. Yesterday, the memories with Lucy seemed endless, but today they appear to be but a few. A few memories shared by family include singing songs from Mamma Mia while braiding my girl's hair, in hairstyles she only knew how to do. Showing up at a moment's notice to give my girls advice on navigating friendship dilemmas, while Michelle and I would peer through the cracked door just watching her in awe. Enjoying camps, summer activities with Abby and her cousins at Ocean Reef, all while teasing Abu about his repeated use of words I cannot repeat here at church. Singing songs with Nina, Katie, and the boys as loud as she could with her squinty eyes and larger-than-life smile. Traveling to Hawaii and riding Thunder Mountain over and over with Kiko, Jess, and the boys. And sharing some laughs while eating chicharrones with Titi or playing Chic Boutique as a child with Nana. Lucy loved dressing up. Taking trips to the islands on the Sweet Melissa with Andy, Melly, and KK. And most recently, Melly telling Lucy she was gorgeous while she was doing her favorite thing in the world, which is being in the water with her friends. It would be disingenuous for me to stand here and say that this tragedy has not evoked an extreme sense of anger, grief, sorrow, disappointment, and a relentless uncertainty as to why her, why now. While we have many beautiful memories of Lucy, some of which I've shared, it's hard not to consume our thoughts and the memories and milestones this tragedy prevented us from experiencing. In these circumstances, for me, it's hard to accept the tragic ending and offer God's will as the only plausible explanation, because that narrative does not bring or does not offer a pathway to bringing our Lucy back. But neither will anger and condemnation. And I know Lucy would not have wanted to leave any of us angry or upset, nor would she want any of us to cast doubt on the faith that she held so dear to her heart. So instead, as a family, we choose to focus on the legacy Lucy is leaving behind. Melly, Andy, and Kevin have exemplified that focus throughout this process in ways I don't think I am capable of modeling, but it is the way that Lucy would have wanted them to handle the crisis, and it is the path Lucy's light has helped to illuminate. The way they have managed the unimaginable with grace, resolve, and unwavering faith gives me hope that there is a path forward, albeit not the path that we would have wanted, but the one that we will embark on together with Lucy's help, guidance, and light. Looking around this room, I'm reminded how Lucy's love has broken down the walls that separate us. We are no longer members of one community, one high school, or one sports club. Today, we are one body, one sisterhood, one brotherhood, one family. And I think we are only beginning to see the ripple effects of this transition that only Lucy could have made happen. There's no question that you all loved Lucy, but Lucy also wanted everyone to love everyone else too. If that is the legacy she leaves behind, bringing us together, tearing down walls that separate us, then what an amazing gift she has left us all. Since her passing, we have sensed Lucy's presence in ways I could not have expected. The mantle at Matheson, which we've seen pictures of, the pictures that flood my Alexa at home with Lucy all over them. The cardinals that fly, the ducks that stare, the flowers that boom, or rather bloom, where never before. Lucy is with us and will always be with us. To her friends, some of which we already have already expressed beautiful words in her honor, Lucy loved you all so much. Know that her love will endure. Even if not in this world, her spirit will make its presence known and continue to love and comfort you when you need it most. Search for her and she will be there. To our family, our Lulu will always be by our side, will continue to be with us during our birthdays, holidays, and even sit with us on Nochebuenas. We may not be able to hug her, but we will never stop feeling her heart and her smile in everything we do. In closing, I'd like to direct my words to Lulu. Lulu, while your time on Earth was short, your impact will be felt by generations. You lived your life with love, left this world as happy as I have ever seen you, and have amazed me in ways I cannot have ever expected. You spoke to us in your college essay and reminded us to see the light over the darkness. With those words, you moved an entire community and will continue to do so through the legacy you leave, a legacy that includes a scholarship fund girls who need it most will be able to access. Your example will be something of which I always remind Natalia and Katerina, and the gifts you have left us, which we are only beginning to see, will be those I cherish the most in this world. Please watch over all of us and keep us close. And if possible, save us some spots in heaven with you, because heaven is where angels belong. And you, my love, are definitely an angel. We love you so much, Lulu, and are going to miss you. Until we see you again, with love always, your Nino.
In the name of the Lourdes Academy school community, I want to express my sincere and deepest sympathy and promise of our continued prayers and support to Melly and Andy, KK, Lucy's grandparents, aunts, uncles, cousins, and all of you who loved her. We at Lourdes Academy also loved Lucy. Our school is a better place because of her, and we miss her. I am grateful to all of you who have supported us as well as the Fernandez family and prayed for us. Your outpouring of love and support is sustaining us during this difficult time. On Friday, when I spoke with Melly and Andy, I promised them that we will keep Lucy's memory alive on our school campus. In her college essay, which Deacon Louie quoted, and so did her uncle, Lucy said that from her birth, she was destined to be the bringer of light. We felt that she was speaking to us, challenging us to use her metaphor, open the blinds each day to see the light shining above the darkness. We believe and we will strive to live and love in this way, like Lucy, each day bringing light over the darkness through our words and our deeds. Melly, Andy, KK, thank you for sharing Lucy with us. God bless you.
And thanks to all of you who spoke for the beautiful, beautiful, and very sincere words that you all spoke. I want to take a moment to thank all those who have joined us today, Monsignor, who was with us for the bulk of the liturgy and who was Lucy's pastor for most of her life. I thank Father Irenaeus, our parochial vicar, who is having joined us today, Father Willie Garcia Tuñon, president of Belen Jesuit High School, Father Robert Valley, Father Ricky Rivera, who are here from the Carrollton School of the Sacred Heart. I also thank the Marist brothers for their presence here. There, some are sitting out in the congregation from Christopher Columbus High School, clearly Deacon Marcos, one of our deacons from this parish, and Deacon Louis, in a very special way, the chaplain at Our Lady of Lourdes Academy, and very especially for those beautiful, beautiful words during the homily. Deacon Louis, as most of you know, was extremely close to Lucy. He knew her very, very well. I also thank the Lourdes singers and our musicians for the beautiful music that they provided us with, all those others who have helped us in this very challenging liturgy, our ushers, the servers, everyone who participated in it. Also, I thank Lieutenant Governor Jeanette Nunez for being here present today, and Mayor Daniela Levine Cava, who also mayor of Miami-Dade County, who joined us throughout the liturgy, for their presence, the cooperation of law enforcement, the cooperation and support of the media, and last but not least, on behalf of the family, thank all of you for being here today, those who are following us on the live stream. I gotta tell you, you gotta have real love to withstand el calor que hay adentro, right? That's what love is, sacrifice, right? And I know the family is deeply, deeply grateful in speaking to them throughout the week. You know, they have very eloquently voiced how blessed they feel to have received the prayers, the support, el cariño of this entire parish community. And our deepest condolences, of course, certainly on behalf of all of us here at Epiphany, go out to you. You know that we're here for you. You know, I often say, well, the liturgy just reminded us, right, that in Christ, life never ends, just continues. Lucy's very alive, more alive than ever, because she is before the Lord without any of the shenanigans that this life presents to her. Any of the obstacles, any of the suffering, she's free from all that stuff. And yes, we've prayed for her eternal rest at this Mass. We pray for her, but I always say that the best thing about eternal life, certainly if you're in the Lord's presence, is there's no unemployment with Jesus. So ask her to pray for you. Put her to work. I have a feeling from everything I'm hearing she'd be more than willing to do that. All these references to light are very interesting, right? Her name, all the accounts of her birth and all the other stuff, and interestingly enough, somebody showed me, they said to me on Tuesday morning, right, the day after she passed, there was this big rainbow, you know, this big old arc, this light in the sky, right, here over South Miami, hovering over Lourdes Academy and Epiphany that morning. Could have been Lucy's way of winking at us. It's always Jesus's way of winking at us. You'll see her again. Keep following the light of the Lord, and everything, everything will come to true light. We will now conclude our liturgy by commending her soul to Almighty God. We will say the prayers here, and then we will proceed with the casket to the entrance of the church to sprinkle her body before we depart for her graveside service. Please be aware that her graveside service is private, is for reserved for family. And, you know, as we begin to proceed with the casket, we invite immediate family to follow us. The rest of you, please remain seated for the sake of safety and order. And thank you again. Thank you very, very much for your wonderful, wonderful cooperation in the midst of these very challenging circumstances. Let us now stand as we present her body and her soul to Almighty Christ. My dear friends, before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet her again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. Let us pray. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our sister Lucy in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Lucy in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our sister forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amazing grace, how sweet.
My dear friends, let us ask Blessed Mother, who always journeys with us, who is present to Lucy, to intercede for her eternal rest and for all of us as we continue to journey on in Christ. Together we say, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women. Blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her. May the soul of Lucy and all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace. Amen. Let us now take our sister to her place of rest. Thanks be to God.